friend, and just like that, I made new friends. So you guys, where are you from?
Hey, I'm Mike, and I'm from Punta Gorda, Florida.
Right.
And I'm Gord. I'm from Ottawa, Canada.
Right. And you guys, how long are you going to be in Newfoundland?
Oh, probably just under, what, 4 days, 5 days?
Yeah, oh, really? So yeah. quick
just
trip.
A short
quick
hop.
Trip,
yeah.
Right. And you guys, where are you from?
I am from Windham, Maine.
And how long are you going to be in Newfoundland?
We're coming back on the 15th on this same boat.
Well, it makes sense because my city is 9,000, so yes. Makes sense, Kinga. Why don't I think about that? Okay, 9, it's us. Top deck. Very flush. Super nice. Reserved seat. Keep it closed. That's me. That's us. Where's our seat? We made it.
Go for coffee.
This looks like a very comfy seat. Well, better than a plane, hey? Because soon there will be loads of people and yeah, it will be probably crowded. I'm pretty sure it's booked out, this ferry, because it is summer holidays. Right, so this is the top of the ferry. See? Ta-da! We still have around 2 hours before we go. Look, there's still so many cars are waiting. Lucky I'm on a bike. I was first. Well, that 7 hours went really fast. I think I slept most of the time. Now we made it. Now I have to pick up Chili, and Chili's standing, that's good. Hello, Chili. Good morning, everyone. Today I've got beautiful sun and I'm about to start my adventure through Newfoundland. But before that, I stopped at my very favorite shop, Canadian Tire, the way to go. These guys sell everything. And my shopping for today includes, well, gas bottle, of course, because I'll be camping and cooking, right? Coffee, at least. And then I also bought bear spray. Yes, I will be going to Labrador after that, and apparently they do have some bears here as well. So yes, I do need that. This thing is super expensive, $50. Oh my god, I have no idea why. Hold on. And I also have a whistle for the bears. This one is a little bit stronger one than the one I have on my lead. I think my lead one that comes with a hydration pack is a bit not strong enough for bears. Yep, no, I don't think they're gonna hear that one. So anyway, I got a bigger whistle. So now we are good to go. Look at this, beautiful, beautiful day. It's gonna be a good day. Wow, this is nice. So I just saw a sign. Now we're going through Table Mountains. So this is the range. Very green, with lots of little lakes. Look. Very nice introduction to Newfoundland, I think. I'll move it this way. Right. Looks like this is our road. We're going on gravel now, I think, maybe, possibly, for at least 160 kilometers, I believe. Yeah, we'll see how we go. But finally, Chile, doing some gravel. Break at the river. So apparently there is like a little waterfall a few k's away, and it is already, oh hold on, you've got a bag there, and it is nearly 5 o'clock, so I reckon it's time to look for a campground, well, camping spot. And from the other side, it looks like that. See it? Very pretty. Right. Well, I was really hoping that I'll be able to camp somewhere next to the waterfall, but it doesn't look like it's gonna happen. So, because this, like, you see this area, it's like all bushy, like there's no turnoffs and everything is sort of on the hill. Julie, it's time to find a place for our tent. Oh wow, look at this road. Whoa, all the way up. Well, Maps Me says there's like a little That's impossible. It says like there is a beach, but it's just a bridge over. Let's go this way. Oh, yeah. This is very beautiful, but I can't see any access for camping. Oh my god, we got what, 41 kilometers to the nearest town where we're supposed to get fuel. So I guess if nothing's gonna pop up before that, I'm gonna end up in town today, which I really didn't want. I wanted to be out in the wild. Anyway, Julie, let's just keep going. Here would be nice too, but it's too close to the road. Not enough space for us, Julie. So difficult. I mean, I'm in the middle of nowhere. It's so remote, and yet I just can't find a spot to put my tent up. Unbelievable. I'm just gonna ask these people here if I can camp at their property. Let's see what they say. Okay, I can't camp here because they have company coming, but they said there should be a few spots on this road, but soon I'm hitting town, so just want to find it before I hit town. Okay, let's keep looking. Right, so this lady said there is a road that goes up and you can see the lake, but it's a shame because I want to be at the lake. I really, really, I'm hoping to finally go for a swim tonight or tomorrow morning. And seems like here on the right hand side there's just properties, but anyway, like, yeah, let's keep looking, Julie. There's still hope. Okay, well, this lady said there is a road that goes up, and thanks to this I'm gonna have a beautiful sort of view at the lake, and there will be a lot of camping spots where I can pull over. So far I don't see any. All these bushes, everything is just so overgrown, it's just absolutely impossible to camp. Like here? I don't think so. And here's what, end of the road? Well, is this the end of the road? I think it is too. Well, that's it. This is where we'll be camping, Chili. I bring you here. And we're done for today. Finally, found a spot for my tent. So yeah, we didn't manage to camp at the lake tonight, so yeah, it's a bit of a shame. I was really hoping I'll be close to the water and maybe go for a swim, because it is a hot day today. Anyway, we can see that lake in the background. So this is sort of like a trail that goes up the hill, but I don't think anyone's been here because it's sort of like overgrown now. Yeah, we got some spot here, which is quite flat. I don't know, the gravel road probably, I don't know, maybe it's 300 meters away, so we out of sight. Chile did well today. We did about what, 100, maybe 50 kilometers on gravel. I really enjoyed that day. It was good fun. Good fun when you just continue on the gravel for quite some time, not just like 10 kilometers here and 10 kilometers there. You know what I mean? Anyway, time to set up my tent. And voila, the house is ready. And I'm off to bed, because I am absolutely exhausted. Another big day tomorrow. Night, Julie! Uh-oh. It does go to the water. Oh, someone's property. Is anyone home? Maybe we could ask if we can camp at the property. Let's, maybe it's just like a summer house. Let's beep. Anyone home? Doesn't look like someone's home. So I keep...